Charlie Jutras is here for the first time ever on Stars and Strikes.
Let's meet our bowlers for this week's match. First, last week's winner, our number four seed from Newington, New Hampshire, Mike Poulin.
Wow, what a job he did with a 430 triple last week. Blasting past Sean McKinley, although it was close at the end. Average 125, his high single is 199. Poulin's high triple 477. The Bowlerama in Portsmouth on Lafayette Ave is where he does his league bowling.
And he'll be taking on a man whose first television appearance came back in 1959 on the old Channel 5 show. That show was hosted by Jim Britt. He becomes the first Candlepin bowler to appear on television in six consecutive decades, the great Charlie Jutras.
Wow.
Into the Guinness World Records book, if they have such a category for that. We're glad to have him and welcome him to WNDS. Charlie's average 128, high single 203. High triple is 475, and all the way out in Western Mass and Southampton, his bowling lane center is Canal Lanes.
Let's get right to it. It's Charlie Jutras and Mike Poulin, our second match of our second ladder series of the new season, and we're coming back to Lita Lanes with this afternoon's match right after this on WNDS-TV's Candlepin Stars and Strikes. We'll be right back. There you see the five bowlers that started our series last week. The first match, Mike Poulin defeating Sean McKinley by 16 pins. Charlie Jutras, today's opponent for Poulin, with Mike Morgan and Steve Reno waiting in the wings. And Mike Poulin will be first to bowl in this match at Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire. A terrific match last week, a tough act to follow. Gave away a lot of bonus money last week, gave Mike Poulin a $225 in bonus money, gave Sean McKinley $75 in bonus money. Both bowlers had a shot at the triple strike jackpot, which is now at $625.
And oh so close for the Mike Poulin attempt. Just a fraction of an inch.
Will he start out with a spare? Yes, he will. The second string last week was a real thriller, with Sean McKinley winning the string 161 to 158. Here's the spare by Mike Poulin starting out. On the spare, he puts a strike. So he'll be shooting at bonus money when he comes right back into it.
That's not a very friendly way to greet our senior elder of Candlepin bowling.
As Mike mentioned, one of the legends in Candlepin bowling, Charlie Jutras from Feeding Hills out in western Massachusetts. Bowls out of the Canal Lanes in Southampton. Bowled on the old Channel 5 show 45 times. A period of time that covered five decades. His first time, 1959. And this is his first ever appearance on WNDS-TV.
Unfortunately, where he lives out in Western Mass in the Springfield area, they don't get our show.
Should be writing letters right away.
That's right.
He opens with a nine box. Charlie, 66 years old. He has four sons, Charles Jr., Neil, Gary, and Chris. He is retired. He worked for 38 years at United Aircraft as an assembler. Right in the pocket. The five pin will go, so the seven is the only one still standing. It's fishing and bass tournament fishing as his hobbies.
He's won some decent stuff doing that.
He and a partner won a $22,000 fishing boat in a tournament sponsored by Foxwoods Casino last year up in Lake Winnipesaukee. Charlie going for the spare will not get it.
Never been in a bass fishing tournament, have you?
No.
Sounds like there's some pretty good money in it, though, huh?
A 10 box for Charlie.
So did I hear you right? He's bowled in six decades.
Well, 1959 was his first time on television with Jim Britt.
He is the Gordie Howe of Candlepin bowling.
So that's the 50s, the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, and here we are in the new century. And here's Mike Poulin looking for some bonus money and in pretty decent shape, I might add. So Mike with a $50 shot coming here. This looks like one you could make, Michael.
Yeah, there's the first shot of the week. Thank you very much, Dick.
$50 in bonus money for Mike Poulin. He'll get another shot at me somewhere down the road.
Well, I think our agents have been speaking, and it looks as though sometime in the spring you and I may be reacquainting each other at Pilgrim Lanes in Haverhill in front of, again, several hundred spectators, as we did last year for the fundraiser at Pilgrim.
I'm ready for you.
You are? So you actually, okay, good. We're making some progress.
I haven't bowled since, but I'll be ready for you. Another $25 shot coming up here for Mike Poulin. Missed the head pin.
Not by much, though.
So he'll not get additional bonus money. He has $50 in the bank. And a nine box.
So your first question that you have to ask Charlie at the end of the show when we stand up and give the presentation, Charlie, were you nervous?
This has got to be old hat to him.
You wonder, though. You really wonder. He hasn't been on TV probably in almost 10 years.
The last year of the Channel 5 show, he told me, and I couldn't recall which year that was.
It would have been about 96, 97.
His last opponent was Tom Olster, he told me.
Oh, geez, what a way to go out, huh?
Spread Eagle almost picking it up. He told me his first opponent was a fellow named Lou Pignali. Is that name familiar to you?
I remember the name, sure.
From the Boston area. Nine bucks for Charlie, looking for his first mark. The name was not familiar to me, so I figured we'd ask the Morgans when they check in. They'd
there
probably know the name.
Our resident historians. And we'll probably get mail now, which is always fine. Send us those press clippings and letters.
We'd love to hear from you.
We
always do. Our mailing address is Candlepin Stars and Strikes, 50 Television Place, WNDS-TV, 50 Television Place, Derry, New Hampshire, 03038. Charlie missed the spare, so he's having a hard time finding his mark here in the first string. Charlie rolled a 674 in the roll-off.
And let me tell you something, Dick. That was with a 99 first game.
Wow.
They bowled five, 99, and then he just went nuts after that.
He has an early 29-pin lead for Mike Poulin.
Charlie's come very close over the last couple of years. He just hasn't been able to get that, you know, that final couple of pins to get onto the show, but he did this time and was actually just five, 6 pins away from being the second seed behind Mike Morgan.
Will he pick up the spare? Almost just that close. He sent the wood sprawling over toward the 7-pin, but was unable to get it to fall. That will be a 10 box for Mike Poulin. What are you doing for lunch today, Michael?
I'm hoping for pizza, my man.
How about heading over to Pizza Hut?
I'm there.
On Amherst Street, just down the street from Lidl Lanes in Nashua, 313 Amherst Street. If you're in the area every Monday through Friday, they have a terrific lunch and buffet. It's an all-you-can-eat buffet from 11:30 to 1 in the afternoon. It includes a salad bar and breadsticks and desserts. And they do a great job, Laurie Christian and her crew, at Pizza Hut at 313 Amherst Street in Nashua, just down the street from Lita Lane's in Nashua.
And we do take advantage of the buffet concept there. Nobody leaves hungry.
85. Through six for Mike Poulin. Now Charlie Jutras looks for his first mark in the first string. Right on the head pin. The 7-pin goes. The 5 and the 9 still stand. The wood is, well, it might be a factor. Could get in the way if it's a factor at all. We'll try to take it without the wood. First mark of the match
nice.
For Charlie Jutras as he slid it past that piece of wood in the middle of the lane. And he's on the board with his first mark. Charlie, very active in the Senior Pro Tour, won 4 of their 6 tournaments last year.
That's amazing, because he's certainly not the youngest man. You know, 50 years of age is where that cutoff begins.
He bounces one down, and he's on the head pin. He'll put 5 in the spare. And the 2 that he didn't win, he finished 2nd and 3rd. He has 6 Senior Tour titles to his credit. I know when you spoke with him earlier, he told you he had a dry spell of 15 years, but he's regained his timing, and he's bowling great again, but you'd have a hard time convincing anybody he was having a dry spell for 15 years as the piece of wood comes back toward Charlie, and it will roll off into the gutter to his left, and they'll replace it afterwards.
I guess he'll shoot with the wood in there, which is his option.
Look at that. knocked the wood away. That'll be a nine box for Charlie.
Yeah, he said it truly was his timing. You talk about persistence, taking 15 years to finally get it back.
A 23-pin lead for Mike Poulin in box seven of the first string. Again, on the head pin, but a little full. The wood is in good position for Mike. With the 2-4-7 on the left, the 6 and 10 on the right. He didn't play the wood, he just played it straight and didn't make the shot.
Mike Poulin finishing fifth at Academy Lanes a couple of months ago, the September WCBC tournament. A tournament that Chris Sargent won, by the way.
10 box for Mike Poulin. He's at 95 through 7. Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV is a presentation of the Thompson family of dealerships, McMulkin Chevrolet, Nashua Hyundai, Nashua Mitsubishi, and Nashua Daewoo, all located in the New England Automotive Village on the Daniel Webster Highway in Nashua, New Hampshire. Four horsemen on the right, the seven pin on the left, and a spare for Mike Poulin. Well done, just like they would diagram it in the how-to book of Candlepin bowling. Watch that head pin slide over and take out that seven pin. Played well by Mike Poulin. Charlie Jutras needs a couple of marks. He's right on the head pin, and there's one.
I noticed him reacquainting himself with a lot of the fans that come to our shows all the time that have followed his career for these last 50 years, 40 years. Old friends, old home day, Charlie Jutras.
I'm sure that some of our fans who come to our tapings weekly remember Charlie from those days. And again, he's right on the head pin. Leaves himself a split, though.
Look at how well he throws that ball. I mean, you just would never know the guy is 66 years old.
Unfortunately, he's got a tough shot. It's the 6 and the 7. Piece of wood to the left. Charlie's sizing up the situation. Trying to figure out the best way to approach it. He might try to play the wood and take a shot at something happening.
I'm just afraid if he hits that wood, it's going to camera on the 7 and miss
what he's doing. He did. It did just that. He took a shot at it. Puts 8 in the strike. He's up against a Mike Poulin mark in the 8th frame. And that'll be an 8 box for Charlie Jutras. He's at 88 through 8. Mike Poulin's at 105 plus a ball.
Well, I didn't grow up in New England, Dick, so I never got to see Charlie in what would have been his prime, although it'd be tough to convince me that he's not having a second prime as a senior bowler.
I'll tell you, the early days of Candlepin bowling on Channel 5 were a real hoot for those of us who grew up in New England and bowled a lot as kids, because it was a real popular show.
They were your heroes, I'm going to guess, in some ways.
They really were, and no exaggeration, it was a show that was talked about after the fact by bowling fans for the each week leading up to each show. Look at that
this.
Shot by Mike Poulin.
Oh, boy. Somebody went to church today.
Double mark for Mike Poulin coming from the backside. Well, Mike Poulin with 5 marks in the first string. 6 marks in the first string and $50 in bonus money. So he has $100 in bonus money in the first string. Mike Poulin is not intimidated by the legendary Charlie Jutras at all, is he?
Well, what does Charlie call him? You remember his nickname? Mike told
Animal.
Us last week. That's right. He says that with great affection and respect.
That one's off the head pin.
Still pulls a 7 out of the bag.
Working on a strike, so he's got another ball to fill the strike.
1, 2, and 8. Got it. Oh, the 8 stays. How
did
that stay up?
9. In the strike and a 151 first string for Mike Poulin. He continues to bowl extremely well. He had a 430 last week.
That's a 143 average for 3 strings. Now if Charlie throws 4 strikes here, he'd only have a 148.
He needs a couple of marks to get close. Keep Mike Poulin within sight. 4 horsemen on the right side.
Charlie still throws a great ball. His accuracy has been just a bit off. A little erratic here in this first string.
Boy, thought he was going to get it.
That when you do that, it makes me more upset than almost anything else because you hit it right where you want to between the one and the three.
And it just didn't take it now. That'll be a 10 box for Charlie. He's at 98. He will trail going into the second string. The question is how badly will he trail? He's could use a mark for sure.
Celebrates his 67th birthday next month, December 16th. Very young 66, I think we'd all agree on that.
Trying to break up the split. Wood all over the deck with the 3, the 7, and the 10. This is not an easy shot by any stretch of the imagination. I think he'll play the right side of that piece of wood that's out front. That's what he's trying to do. Not going to make the shot, though. The 10 pin still stands.
I didn't know that you were his coach. Wow.
That's not the pin I expected to still be standing after that shot, by the way. That's a 10 box for Charlie, a 108 for a string, and he's got a mountain to climb. He's trailing by 43 pins going to string number 2 of our second match of this second ladder series on Candlepin Stars and Strikes. The winner advances to take on number 2 seed Mike Morgan next week. We're coming back with the second string of today's match at Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire, right after this on WNDS-TV. Charlie Jutras will be first to bowl in our second string here this afternoon. He trails Mike Poulin by 43 pins. Mike a scorching 151 in the first string. Charlie off the head pin there as we start out string number 2.
Runner-up today, $225. And the winner, of course, faces Mike Morgan next week.
That's a good way to start the second string for Charlie Jutras, picking up a very difficult spare. Watch it one more time. After a first shot that was off the head pin, he had 6 pins standing, and he managed to make the shot.
You know that in his many years of bowling, he's probably made every combination spare and split known to man.
This is on the head pin. He'll put 7 in the spare, and he's got a spare opportunity with the wood seated between those pins. That's the 6, the 9, and the check it, the 3, the 5, and the 9 pins.
Yeah, the side saddle triangle, as it's called, and very, very good wood.
There it is. 2 marks in a row for Charlie Jutras starting out as he finds the range here in the second string. Mike Poulin has had the range for the last couple of weeks. A 430 last week, a 151 in the first string. This afternoon, Mike Design is a design consultant and in-ground pool specialist for Custom Pools in Newington, New Hampshire. He and Judy have been married for 19 years. They have 3 children. Stephen is 15, Tommy is 14, David is 13. And look at that shot by Mike Poulin as he played it well and left the 10 pin still standing. Ten box to start out for Mike Poulin, who is no stranger to television as well. He was on Channel 5's old show One Time Bowling Singles and about 20 times in doubles competition, and he's been on WNDS Candlepin Bowling Show some 25 times over the past 17 years. That's how long we've been on. This show has been on. Michael and I are in our 4th season together.
Hard to believe it's already our 4th year together.
There's a great shot by Mike Poulin to pick up the spare. Watch it again after a half Worcester. He picks up the spare. That's not an easy shot. Charlie Jutras looking for some bonus money right here. He has 2 marks in a row. He'll put 6 in the spare and leave himself the 2, 4, 5, and 7.
Well, he's gotten 13 pins back from the 40 or so pins that he was trailing. After one string.
Not going to pick up the spare. Put the bonus money back in the vault.
Shoot this one on the inside. Hope for a deflection.
He went to the outside. Will he get it? It's still wobbling. It's not going down. There it goes.
Got ahead to pull the string there at the end to get it to go down.
I was going to call for an investigation to see if there were nails sticking out of the lane.
Let's show a little respect here for Mr. Jutras, please.
There's Charlie on the head pin. He could have some pretty good wood. Nope, that wood's going to roll away. I thought it was going to turn and angle and roll back toward the...
Right. If it would have stopped on the plate, it would have turned around. But he's probably really better off with a straight-on, unobstructed shot.
3, 5, and 6. Missed the 3-pin. That was the key pin.
Yeah, he's getting a bit of a tail on the ball from right to left, which on a few occasions has hurt him today.
And that'll be a 10 box for Charlie, but he needs marks, not 10s. 53 through 4, and Mike Poulin's working on a mark.
Charlie is also bowling with the WCBC, the bowlers in the regular tour, and had a 12-36 in the September tournament in Bradford Academy Lanes.
Mike Poulin right in the pocket that time, a solid shot, leaving the 6 and the 9 pin.
In that same tournament, Mike Poulin finished 5th behind Chris Sargent. He had 13-22 to come in 5th place. We don't have the October results because we are actually taping this program a few days before the tournament is held.
You're letting away all our secrets.
I'm sorry.
Played it to the outside. Ooh, great try by Mike Poulin as he tried to avoid the wood in the middle of the lane and played the shot on the outside of the 6-pin, but hit it too full. And he'll end up with a 9 box.
Can't tell you that up in Sanford, Maine today, the WCBC is bowling its final shifts. Probably about 2:45, I think, is when the final squad goes off. So if you are in that area, want to watch these pro bowlers, you can have a look at them today.
Mike right on the head pin, straight through with a spread eagle. The 2, 4, and 7 on the left, the 3, 6, and 10 on the right.
Today being November 5th, by the way. First time the show runs.
Whoa! Almost. We talked last week about this being one of the toughest shots, if not the toughest shot to make in all of Candlepin bowling.
Well, we've seen it 2, maybe 3 times in the last 3 years, and we've seen triple strikes more than that.
Good 10 box from Mike Poulin. He's at 47. Charlie's picked up 6 pins. And we're going to take a break. We'll come back. A 37-pin lead in the match for Mike Poulin over Charlie Jutras. We're nearly halfway through this second match of our second ladder series from Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire. Don't go away. We're coming back for more right after this on WNDS-TV. Veteran Charlie Jutras stands on lane 34 at Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire. He trails Mike Poulin by 37 pins as we near the halfway point of this match. Poulin a 151 in the first string, Jutras a 108. Jutras a little thin on the Brooklyn side of the head pin.
Left a lot of those kinds of combinations so far with the thin hits.
The 3, 5, 6, and 10 are still standing. They are still standing. The 10 pin is still standing. Charlie gives it the good body English after just about every shot. And that will be a 9 box for Charlie. I almost had that one already in the in the column.
It's the first pin he's left standing this string. 62 through 5.
Difficult, and I think probably if Tony Zernike were here, he'd be a good source of information. But going back to 1959, when Charlie Jutras first made his TV appearance, some of the names of some of the bowlers who were on in those early years of Candlepin bowling on television became household names. I think of bowlers that come to mind. Dick Chafee is a name that comes to mind. Tony Baldinelli, of course, comes
sure.
to mind. A 9 box for Charlie. Some of those guys who were really successful way back in the early days of the TV show. Unfortunately, when you put on the spot and start to think about names like that, you can't recall very many of them. Mike Poulin. Just 1 mark thus far in the second string.
We need to hook up with Phil Rubin, the old director of the Channel 5 show.
A mark for Mike Poulin in the 5th frame, his 2nd mark of the string. Put 7 in the spare. He He regains the lead in the string, does Mike Poulin, and adds a couple of pins to his match advantage.
All right, coach, what do we do with this wood out here?
Just throw it down the middle and close your eyes. That's what he did. Exactly as you suggested. Watch it again. Almost right on the red stripe of that piece of wood out in front.
More often than not, though, you're going to leave something after that shot. Now Charlie finds himself a few pins behind this string after having the lead for a bit.
He needs to run a few marks. That's right on the head pin. Oh, he knocked a piece of deadwood out from between those two pins, which would have been to his advantage, but he's got the open shot at the 4 and the 8. And a spare for Charlie Jutras. Charlie has a high single of 203, a high triple of 475.
And I dare say the 203 was probably shot when the game was a little tougher to score in.
On the spare, right on the head pin, but a little bit too full on the head pin. Just put 6 in the spare. 3, 6, and 10 on the right. The 4 pin stands on the left. No wood on the lane. He'll just take one.
It's amazing, averaging 128.
7 blocks for Charlie. Going back to the days again, you talk about the late 50s, early 60s, when Charlie first appeared on TV, if you averaged a 105, 106, 107, close to 110, you were considered really to be a spectacular Candlepin bowler.
And by the way, it's still not a shabby average to have today. It doesn't get you on this show too often, although we've had a couple bowlers under 110 average be on our show. Dave Oliveri comes to mind a year or two ago.
$50 shot from Mike Poulin. 3 marks in a row from Mike, who's putting the pedal to the metal right here. Another spare. That's a 4 horsemen on the right that go. He has $150 in bonus money in the match thus far. And if he adds more bonus money with this shot, that would really be something. Not going to happen. That's a great 10 box right there from Mike Poulin.
I will go back and correct the score sheet. It is not correct.
Charlie Jutras needing some marks in the 8th frame of the second string.
Corrected score for Mike Poulin through 8 is 103. Charlie Jutras, 94. My scorekeeping guardian angel, El Chester, behind me, helping me out here.
Charlie's not converting. He's not making the shots.
El Chester shows up every taping just to remind me that he beat me in the amateur Candlepin tour in the finals a couple of years ago. Well, better than a couple of years ago now.
That's one of the reasons I come every week, too. There's the scoreboard for you right there. Is Charlie Jutras with a 104 through 9. Mike Poulin has 103 through 8.
I do have one title to my credit, though. I did win one tournament.
Charlie on the headpin, really right on top of the headpin.
Tour had as much or more money than the Pro Tour did, Dick, and it ran every week, where the first prize was $600, $700, $800 or more.
Wait a minute, amateur money? I thought amateurs were supposed to be not for money.
Well, it's how you want to use the word amateur. Professional, as in these guys are proficient. We were just hackers getting handicapped. But the money still spends, pal.
Charlie finishes with a 112 in the second string. And a 2-string total of 220. He's going to trail Mike Poulin by a considerable amount heading into the third string.
It's actually a very great tournament circuit that went all over New England. Had hundreds of members at its heyday, and I'm sorry to say it just isn't around anymore. I'm not sure what happened.
Mike had a good break. That was not a solid shot. Looked to me like he was going to have a lot of pins standing, and then they all got wiped out except for the 3 and the 10, and they're still standing, the 3 and the 10 are. So he'll be open in the ninth.
No 150 game this time around.
That'll be a 10 box. He's at 113. He's already adding to his lead in the match. He leads by 44 pins, plus whatever he gets in this last box of the second string. And a tough shot for Mark. A 50-pin lead.
Look,
will it go? Will the 7-pin go? It danced. Hard to imagine it's still standing, but it danced.
Especially with a couple pins leaning against it. It's amazing.
Looks like it's halfway off the lane down in the corner with the angle that we have. That'll be a 10 box for Mike Poulin, and he'll finish with a 123. He will take a 54-pin lead into the final string of this match with Charlie Jutras as we come back for the third string of today's match from Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire. It's Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV. Don't go away. We're coming back for more right after this. Mike Poulin will be first to bowl in the third string of this afternoon's match on Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV. Dick Lutsk with Mike Morin. Happy to have you with us for this second match of the season, of this second ladder series of the season. Mike Morin, by the way, you can hear him every morning. It's Morin in the Morning on WHOB 106.3 FM in Nashua, New Hampshire. How's it going?
We're having fun, causing all kinds of trouble.
Haven't read about you lately. You haven't had anything, any
no
suspensions
more,
or anything like that?
No tall ships, pranks yet, but you never know what I could be cooking up.
And yeah, 9 box for Mike Poulin to open up.
Peg Jett, my news partner, and Cannonball Ken Kale, our sports guy. We'd love to have you fill in next time Kenny's on vacation.
Give me a call.
Doesn't pay anything.
I'm used to that. All the coffee and donuts you can get, right?
That's it. Yeah. You can even do it from home if you like.
Sure, happy to do it.
You can do it in your jammies.
Oh, nice shot by Mike Poulin. Great shot by Poulin. He takes a sigh. You got a good look of him sighing after that shot, walking back. Let's look at it one more time. Played well by Mike Poulin. Good spare from Mike in the second box. Charlie Jutras has a mountain to climb.
They gave it a little more zip. Didn't help the accuracy. Had a little more speed, which broke up some of the back pins, leaving the one and the two.
Now, head pin is key, obvious. That's a spare for Charlie Jutras to start out.
Yeah, a little more steam on his ball. Maybe he's going to try just to go for a little more pin action that way.
You're going to tell Charlie Jutras how to bowl, right?
I'm just observing here. I'm just a kid wondering how he ever did it this long, this well.
Six decades.
Yeah, stunning.
Little thin on the head pin. Good action after the shot, though. Put eight in the spare, but leave a tough shot to make. That's the 3 and the 7.
Charlie strikes me as the kind of guy that would listen to people telling him and helping him. I just get that feeling.
Gave it a shot, tried to slide the 3-pin over to the 7-pin. Threw it past the 3-pin on the right side. That's what he was trying to do.
Yeah.
Exactly what he was trying to do with the second shot. And
the Jutras touch on that.
Terrific
one.
Shot for the 10 box with Charlie Jutras.
Still got it.
Mike Poulin works on a spare. He will put 8 in the spare. And the 7 and the 10, the goalposts are still standing. There's wood on the deck. I don't know. I might go to the right side with that extra piece of wood and see if you can spray something.
I would agree with that.
That's what he tried to do, but he leaves the 7-pin still standing.
Well, we haven't given much of Ray Simoneau's money away this week compared to last.
Well, we gave we've given $150 away to Mike Poulin, which isn't too shabby. Well,
last week
bucks.
We gave away close to $300, I think.
Yep. $225 to Mike, and Sean McKinley had $75. This is the 4 in the 7th. Still standing with some wood out there for Mike Poulin.
Charlie Jutras needs to take advantage of these Mike Poulin splits.
Can't take advantage of that. It's made by Mike Poulin. That's a good shot by Mike. Second spare of the third string. 2 marks and 4 boxes for Poulin. Charlie Jutras needs to mark.
I guess we're so humdrum now with all these great shots, we don't see instant replays of them, huh? Just kidding, guys.
Charlie right on the head pin. There they go. Charlie looks back at the crowd. Let's take a look at it one more time.
I think we can manage it. Oh, there we go.
There we go.
Look at the way those 2 pins in the corners collapse.
It takes a while. There it goes. They go simultaneously. Now Charlie working on the strike. Needs another one. Bounces that one down.
Double dribbler almost went for a strike.
Got the 6 and the 10 on the right side. The wood takes a left turn, angles away. Now Charlie has to figure out how to play the wood here. Virtually impossible to get around the wood. And a spare for Charlie Jutras. A couple of marks in a row as we go to the break. He has 3 marks and 4 boxes in the third string as he tries to climb back into it. And he bows to the crowd. And we're going to the break. And Charlie Jutras trailing Mike Poulin. 6 boxes to go. Don't go away. We're heading down the home stretch. It's Candlepin Stars and Strikes continuing from Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire on WNDS-TV. Mike Poulin ready to go after the break, takes his warm-up jacket off and heads to lane 34. At Lita Lanes, he has a lead of 43 pins with 6 frames remaining. Both boxes, both bowlers are working on marks in the 4th frame. A spirited crowd here at Lita Lanes today. A great crowd, another great crowd on hand. And working on the mark, he'll put 8 in the spare and leave a makeable shot.
You'd almost swear that the Morgans were in the house already, or anticipating next week's visit by Mike Morgan and brother Tom.
Spare for Mike Poulin. 2 marks in a row, 3rd mark of the string. So he keeps the pressure on Charlie Jutras, who has 3 marks in the first 4 boxes. That one's off the head pin, but he got a good pin drop. He'll put 8 in the spare, and again, another makeable shot. Got the 1 and the 2 still standing. He missed the head pin.
Cost him a little money, $50.
Did a little acrobatic dance at the line, trying to root that ball over a little bit more. Didn't get there. 10 box for Mike Poulin. He's at 83 through 6. Charlie Jutras looks for some bonus money and looks to put some pressure on Mike Poulin. Looks to inch a little bit closer. He has 2 marks in a row, 3 marks in the first 4 boxes of the third string. He got the head pin, but a little bit thin on it. That piece of wood's coming out and headed down right toward Charlie. It'll be replaced.
Paul Ouellette is our scorekeeper and official pin runner every week, succeeding Chris Beauvais, who was last year's Tournament of Champions winner. Certainly Paul hopes to, I suppose, fill those shoes someday. I don't know much about him as a bowler, but I'm going to guess he's probably a good one.
Charlie got it in a most unconventional way, but he got it. Watch it again. That's a $50 shot for Charlie Jutras. Kicking it off the wall and kicking the 10 pin back to take the 5 pin out is a very unusual way to get that shot.
He now has a 1 pin lead in completed boxes, and he'll be up against a Poulin open frame in the 6th.
It's on the head pin. Can he break up the split?
That didn't help himself, though, with the 5-pin going down.
And the wood coming off the lane.
Yeah, didn't help him at all.
Charlie again looks back at the crowd and with the sigh.
Gets the sympathy groans from his longtime five-decade friends and fans here on hand today at Lita Lanes. It's a way to make it is to try to get some action off the sidewall. Hit it too full, though.
In the 10 box, he's gained back 9 pins. A 45-pin lead from Mike Poulin with 4 boxes remaining, and time is running out on Charlie Jutras. Four horsemen on the left side, the 7-pin in the corner, the wood angled nicely. For Mike Poulin, and the lefty comes at it from the left side. Did not get the shot. The 10-pin still stands. Box for Mike Poulin. I think it's safe to say that Charlie Jutras will have to run the table with the final 4 frames.
Mike Poulin, owner of 3 WCBC titles, including the 6th stop last year at Fairway Sports Center in Natick, the final tournament stop of last year.
That pin wobbles.
And the other pin's holding it up.
The 3-pin wobbled and the dead wood just didn't let it fall. From the left side, he comes at it, and he makes the spare. Continuing to apply the pressure to Charlie Jutras. That's the 4th mark of the 3rd string for Mike Poulin. Charlie on the pocket. Right in the pocket, leaving the 8 pin.
Let's give him the strike. Do you think Mike Poulin would mind?
Oh, boy. Looked like that was a no-brainer as it left his hand and hit the pocket, but the 8-pin wouldn't listen.
Yeah.
Charlie caught the edge of the deadwood. That was going to nail the pin. It was right on it, but the wood got in the way.
It's an aggravating game at times.
10 box for Charlie Jutras. Tens won't help him. He's up against a mark by Mike Poulin in the 8th frame.
The man that Charlie Jutras calls animal, Mike Poulin. After a 4:30 last week, you'd have to agree with that. Nickname fits.
He's going to have a shot at another 400 triple, will Mike Poulin.
Oh, yeah. I would say he's pretty much a cinch for that. Needs 126 this game. He's in good shape for that.
Charlie with the wood angled on the right side. We'll try to take it that way. Not gonna make it.
Well, I'll bet you we see Charlie back before too long, the kind of year he's been having so far.
10 box for Charlie. And I believe mathematically,
well, he
could
get
quite over. Almost. Mike Poulin puts 7 in the spare.
404 is possible for Charlie Jutras. And that would be quite a feat.
Ten box for Poulin. He's at 120. 394 needs a 6 for 400.
And 11 pins to shout out Charlie Jutras.
If Charlie strikes out the rest of the way.
That's right.
Well, there he goes. There's the mark. Anything above a 1 and this match is over.
Back-to-back 400s for Newington, New Hampshire's Mike Poulin, who will advance next week to meet crowd favorite, Mike Morgan of Lynn.
He'll finish with a strike on top of the spare and a 140. And a 414 for Mike Poulin. A terrific triple and $150 in bonus money to boot.
414 is what his opponent had last week, Sean McKinley, losing to Mike Poulin. 414 will be good enough this week against favorite Charlie Jutras.
Well, he was right on the object pin that time and put it right through. We'll have our bonus ball contest, which you can participate in each week by sending in a postcard with your name, address, and pick a number from 0 through 10. Send it to Bonus Ball Contest, care of Lita Lanes, 340 Amherst Street, Nashua, New Hampshire, 03063. Our winning bowler, Mike Poulin, will be bowling a ball shortly, and we'll try to match him up with a winner at home. We had a cash winner last week of $50. We're back to $10 in the bonus ball jackpot this week. And if the numbers don't match, a nice consolation prize from NNR Trophies in Winchendon, Massachusetts. Well, Charlie will be open again. And he'll finish with a 129 and a three-string total of 349 for Charlie Jutras. And an impressive win for Mike Poulin, 414 to 349 over Charlie Jutras. And we'll come back to meet our bowlers. And look ahead to next week with Mike Morgan waiting in the wings when we come back to Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire, right after this on Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV.
We're running a little bit short on time. Charlie Jutras is standing next to me. Charlie, a check for $225, $50 in bonus money, 6 decades of bowling on television. Do you still get nervous?
Oh, yeah, you do. Yeah.
Great to see you. Hope to see you again soon. Charlie Jutras, our runner-up here this afternoon. Our winner, Mike Poulin, will bowl a bonus ball. We'll try to match him up with a winner at home. It looks like it'll be a 6. And Mike Morin dips into the bag, and let's check the card, make sure all the information is there.
I believe it
is. And it is. It looks like Phyllis Mancuso from Everett, Massachusetts, and her guess was 7. So we have a consolation prize from NNR Trophies of Winchendon, Massachusetts, and Mike Poulin, a 414 triple, another $150 in bonus.